Hello and welcome. This is your favorite Fortified tech support engineer, Ethan here, bringing you another video demonstration. With the release of WebInspect 20.2 in November came a number of new features and enhancements to the product. One of our greatest challenges, with the exception of endpoint protection and intrusion detection or prevention systems, was our reliance on Microsoft's Schannel. Historically, WebInspect has utilized Microsoft's Schannel built into the Windows operating system. Recently, many system administrators and security professionals have made the decision to lock down servers and workstations. Well, this broke the functionality of WebInspect when we wanted to test the detection of and the utilization or implementation of these on web servers or web applications. Obviously, with our reliance on Microsoft's Schannel and the decision to block this functionality at the OS level, we cannot perform these tests and would often generate errors. Well, no more. Starting with WebInspect 20.2, we have integrated OpenSSL into WebInspect. This integration allows WebInspect to support all versions of SSL and TLS, even TLS 1.3. And it also allows us to get around the Schannel errors on machines where customers have made the decision to disable weak protocols and ciphers at the OS level. In my lab, I've disabled the weak ciphers and protocols by using Nartec Software's IIS crypto. As you can see, these have been disabled and only TLS 1.2 and a couple of other ciphers are currently enabled. We can verify this by going to browserleaks.com/SSL. And in here, we will see that TLS 1.3 is not enabled, as well as TLS 1.0 and TLS 1.1. Now let's see how this would look in a scan. I've started a basic scan and defined the 0.webappsecurity.com site. We're restricting it to the directory and subdirectories. Site authentication, I am going to choose an already created login macro. And then we are going to basically accept the defaults for the rest of it. While that's running, I want to open up and start a script, a PowerShell script that monitors the Windows system event log for any Schannel errors. As you can see, we've already created some errors simply by profiling the site. During profiling, we're going out and doing some fingerprinting of the server and the web application, and that is already generating some Schannel errors, as you see from the script. Let's take a look at the scan log. We see that the scan is currently testing our login macro, and if you look at the results from the script, you see that we are still generating some Schannel errors. Here we see that the macro test failed because it was unable to successfully connect to the website. Now let's go to the application settings and use OpenSSL. We will need to restart the login macro recorder in order for those settings to take effect. We're going to go back to browserleaks.com/SSL and take a look and see what the results are. And we see that TLS 1.3 is enabled, as well as 1.0 and 1.1. Let's go start a new scan and see if we get any more errors. I'm starting another basic scan for 0.webappsecurity.com, adding the same macro that was recorded and used for the initial scan or the first scan, checking to see if we are generating any SQL errors, and we should not, because again, we are not relying on SChannel, we're using OpenSSL. And click scan. Take a look at the scan log again. The macro successfully completed this time, so that we were successful in the test. And in just a few seconds, you will see the site tree start populating and the scan will succeed or continue on as expected. I have another scan that I ran earlier that will show the completed results of the scan without any errors and successful completion using OpenSSL. And as you can see on the scan log, we have no errors, and on the findings we do have results. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Hit the like and subscribe button and stay tuned to the Fortify Unplugged channel for more videos.